Hi, and welcome to Man Cave Garage Workshop. Today we're going to talk about a do-it-yourself Ironton folding trailer that I picked up at Northern Tools. I got this trailer about 3 years ago, put it together for kayaks that we were buying at the time. So this is really a kayak trailer that we use for other transporting as well. So let's take a look at what we've got. This is really a true DIY. The trailer came in three boxes. The first one had the tires, fenders, springs, casters, lights, the trailer tongue, a license plate holder, and all the parts to connect the frames. The other two boxes had the frame for the front and the back sections. Here's an important tip. There is a title for the trailer in one of the boxes. This needs to be signed at the store. If you get the trailer, don't leave the store without getting it signed. It's important to note that these tires are only rated for up to 55 miles an hour. Now, this trailer has been on the highway multiple times at faster speeds, but there are tires out there that have a higher rating if you'll be exceeding that threshold often. Here I've started to lay out the rails for the frame. The front and back and right and left rails are specific pieces. Pay attention as they're not interchangeable. I definitely recommend laying them out as I have here before you put them together. I also recommend dumping all the nuts and bolts and separating them. It would be easy to reach in the bag and accidentally grab one of the larger bolts and attach it and find out later that you're missing a large bolt and have to go figure out where you put it. Of course, I wouldn't know myself, but I hear that can happen. The four carriage bolts are to lock the folding platform in place, but I have something else for that. There are plenty of lock nuts, and it actually came with way more than you need. Here you can see we've got the full frame together folded in half. The axles, fenders, tongue, and mount for the casters are all ready to go. Flipping it over, we got the wheels on with the base unfolded. Next up, wiring. The wiring diagram really wasn't that great. You'll want to run the wires inside the length of the tongue and inside the rails. There aren't a ton of places to zip tie it into, but I was able to make it all work. The black plastic wrapping that you see didn't come with the trailer. I got this to protect the wires from anything kicking up and damaging them. I found it easier to do the wiring with the trailer all folded up. This is actually important as this will allow you to make sure there's enough gap in the wire when you fold it so you don't have a frustrating problem later when you realize you can't fold it because the wiring doesn't have enough of a gap. I went ahead and used liquid electrical tape and will put heat shrink wrap over the top to get as much protection as I can at the connection points. And finally, the black plastic wrap over the top when it's all done. The taillights are really the only place that I have any wire exposed at all.
So that hook right there holds it down. The trailer came with some bolts, but you can see the location is really hard to get to. So instead I got these U-clamps that work really well.
Next up is the trailer light electrical connector. One doesn't come in the kit, so you'll need to pick one up that fits the connection to your vehicle and then attach it to the wiring. Now the Ironton kit is complete. Here's another tip. Pick up a set of casters to replace the ones that came in the kit. The ones that came in the kit were really cheap and impossible to get on, so I went ahead and upgraded them. I also put an extra nut between the caster and the frame. The kit doesn't come with flooring. You'll need to pick up some plywood. A good 4x8 3/4 inch sheet ripped right in half works perfectly. Because of the way the metal frame connects together, there would be gaps between the wood and the frame in some spots, mainly down the middle. Since that would eventually result in a warped floor, here you can see where I glued scrap pieces of a 1/4 inch plywood to the bottom where those gaps would otherwise be, and then drilled holes to attach it all to the frame. I went and painted the underside a flat black to help protect from any wetness that might cause any warping later on. And finally, for the top, I used a few thick coats of truck bed liner. I figured this is the best way to get some longevity out of it, and so far I'm really happy with the results. An important part I missed earlier are the clamps. These are used to attach sides to the trailer. There are two on each side and each end. You can also see that I added hooks around the outside to be able to use tie downs for any loads that I will be carrying on the trailer. These didn't come in the kit, but you can pick them up on Amazon at the links in the description, and the bolts that came with the kit can be used to attach them. I originally got a single front wheel to make it easy to move around the garage. Over time, I noticed that since it doesn't handle the weight evenly, this can cause it to list to the opposite side, so I ended up adding a second wheel. If you aren't going to leave it in the unfolded position, the second wheel probably isn't necessary. If you do though, you will need to get a couple of shorter bolts to attach them to the frame so that the wheel will clear the bolt when you flip it back. Now I needed some sides for the trailer. The frame for the sides is made out of 2x4s. I've seen others make them out of 1x4s, but since there were going to be heavy kayaks sitting on top of the sides, I needed to make sure they were going to be strong. I used scrap 2x4s to ensure that the spacing was even all the way around, along with some straps and clamps to hold them in place while I got it all bolted together. The hooks at each corner along the top to keep the frame strong was a clutch purchase. As you can see, I picked up the spare tire and attached it with a U-hook and a couple of bolts.
When you're building your sides, you want to put the post in and then drill your hole. Don't do it ahead of time because you want to make sure you get it lined up. I couldn't find pins that were the correct length, so I've got some nuts and the cotter pin to stick in the end so it's easy to take out.
I bolted more tie downs on the pillars that hold the kayaks. These complement those that I already put on the frame at the corners and in the middle. I used 1.5-inch lag bolts for these. This also gives me more options to carry loads more securely. We've all seen some crazy loads and trailers going down the road without any straps at all. Don't let that be you. I painted the sides black and finally got everything bolted together. It wasn't as easy as I thought it would be. Here you can see a better close-up of those clutch corner latches that I mentioned earlier. I hooked the trailer to the car and it was ready to go. First trip, pick up some new furniture. Then I was finally ready to pick up our two brand new kayaks. Until that is, we decided to get 4 kayaks instead. This required some ingenuity so I can get all of them on the trailer without starting the sides from scratch. I added the uprights and crossbars to stack the kayaks 2 and 2. I put carpeting on the top rack to make it easier to slide on and off. The kayaks are heavy, 75 pounds a piece, so I put these triangle blocks on to secure the top crossbar. The carpeted crossbars didn't really work out as well as I'd hoped, so then I had to make these carpeted 2x4 rails, which actually makes it really easy to slide the kayaks on and off. Thanks for watching this video, and if you enjoyed it, don't forget to subscribe. If you're going to build one yourself, good luck. Post any questions, and I'll do my best to answer them. We'll see you next time at Man Cave Garage Workshop.